Namami Chinmayam Devam Sadgurum Brahma Vidvaram Vasudeva Sutam Devam Kamsa Chanura Mardhanam Devaki Paramanandam Krishnam Bande Jagadgurum Tvameva Mata Cha Pitattvameva Tvameva Bandhuscha Sakhattvameva Tvameva Vidya Dravidam Tvameva Tvameva Sarvam Amadeva Deva Tvameva Sarvam Gurudeva Deva. Hari Om. We are now starting with the 12th chapter. We completed the 11th chapter where Janaka Maharaj of the Ashtavakra Gita, where the sage Ashtavakra taught Janaka Maharaj, and after realization, Janaka Maharaj is only telling what his state of mind is, that he is pure self, and that is of the nature of pure Chit Swarupam. Now he is continuing that and going to discuss the glory of the self. Why should I realize the self? And this is why he is differentiating what a beautiful it is. So it is, I am looking for all the time for this only, and it is not the what I am going to get out of self. This is what I am searching for. Everyone is searching for happiness, but happiness is not out there. Happiness comes from myself only. But for that I had to establish that I am Purnam and Sat Swarupam, and which is Egameva Advitiyam, without any perturbations of any kind. I am as I am, full, and therefore Ananda Swarupam also. For that is the very fulfillment of life itself. And here says the glory of self Janaka Maharaj is discussing in this 12th chapter, and how to abide in this self, how to realize that self once we so see that beauty of the self. Janaka uvacha kaya krutya saha purvam kaya krutya saha purvam tato vak vistara saha sato vak vittara saha atachinta saha tasmat evam eva aham astitaha. So evam eva aham astitaha, this part will be repeated. And I am that I am, evam eva aham, that alone that I am, which is indifferent to anything else. And I am abiding in the nature of that pure self, I am that I am. That means there is nothing other than that I am. And before, kaya krutya saha purvam, before I have understood this, I am trying to understand, I am trying to gain this knowledge by trying to avoid all other things. Kaya krutya saha. So kaya krutya saha. That means intolerant about the activities at the body level. Kayena vacha manasendriyeva buddhyatmanava prakriti svabhavat. And kaya vacha manaha. This is karomi yajjas sakalam parasmai narayanati payami. I am doing kaya with the activities at the body level, at the mind level, at the intellect level. Kayena manasa, at the speech level. And kaya krutya saha. So all those activities I was trying to avoid because I want to be, I am recognize that I am akartaha. So mind wants to avoid, wants to perform action, then I am trying to withdraw the mind from that. So it is a struggle itself. So I have a asaha, means intolerant for the activities in the world. So I am trying to avoid all the activities in the world. I am beyond activities I want to be, and I am sitting in one meditation seat trying to avoid all any action at the body level. And tato vak vistarasaha, and also activities at the speech level. So I am trying to observe maunam, and maunam is by forcibly avoiding talking unnecessarily, and therefore the minimization of the speech itself becomes one struggle that I was trying. So I was intolerant to unnecessarily speak anywhere or involved in the walk communications. Ata chinta saha. On the same way, I am also about the chinta here is the activities at the mental level, the body level, speech level, and at the mind level. That mind level includes both the emotional aspects as well as the intellectual aspects. So all activities at the mind level, all activities at the speech level, all activities at the body level, that means the karmendriyas and jnanendriyas where action is involved, all activities I was reluctant, and to the degree that I am intolerant, asaha. But I recognize I am beyond all these things. I am neither an actor or neither a speaker. The speech is only indriyarteshu vartante. So speech is only at the level of the indriyas, the sense organs, and sense organs are varied in the sense. But I have nothing to do with it. It is only the activities at the superficial level, and it's like looking at the ocean trying to say, I want to stop all my waves. So this ocean cannot stop all the waves. It is natural to have ocean, to have waves. But at the same time, recognize, ocean has to recognize, there are no waves in me. I am pure water, unperturbed. The waves and all only perturbation at a superficial level, that is, I am unaffected by any of them. And in fact, I am there as a glory of me only. I am immaculately waveless ocean that I am. The waves only superficial, that is only a perturbation at the surface level, but that doesn't affect me at all. So that understanding the ocean should have. Same way, activities at the body level, activities at the mind level, activities at the intellect level, initially I have to control it to keep myself, the mind, invested in the total withdrawal of everything and put it in the higher. That means that is the introvertedness is encouraged as a sadhaka, and first I do at the activity to minimize the activities and vasanas. I am doing karma yoga, bhakti yoga. So these activities are the two levels. One is the spiritual activities and another is the transactional at the religious activities and secular activities. So I am doing puja and pujanam japa chintanam kramat. So I am doing puja rituals I have to do in the morning, and then I have to sit down in the meditation of Gayatri japa, this japa, and so many number of times. All that activities are going on, and that is the religious type of spiritual activities. At the same time, I have to live in this world, and for that the body is required, and the body has to be maintained. So body has to be comfortable enough so that it doesn't get affected by the extremities of the weather, or also the body requires certain food, and the body has been used certain kind of food from the childhood on, and wants to, and is comfortable, settles with that kind of food only. But if it is not available, at least some food for the body maintenance, otherwise body will not be available for me to use. Why do I need a body? Because I had to use the body, I had to use the mind to go beyond the body and the mind. So instruments are required for even self-realization also, because self-realization is only at the level of the mind. Mind has a problem, not Sachidananda doesn't have, Brahman doesn't have any problem. He is ekameva advitiyam, one without a second, so he doesn't have any problem. The mind thinks I am an independent conscious entity. That mind has to go to a teacher, and the vijnanartham sa gurum eva abhigachet, says for that you have to approach a teacher. To whom? The mind only. The mind has to approach the teacher, and mind cannot go. With the body you have to approach the teacher, and with proper attitude, and then the listen, body has to be there, mind has to be there. The body cannot be somewhere else and the mind listening there. So body, mind, everything, equipments are required as a sadhana, as a for education, for evolution also. But at the same time, you reach a state of mind where I want to withdraw my mind from the activities at the body level, activities at the speech level, activities at the intellect level, and contemplate single-pointedly in the direction pointed out by that I am pure consciousness, unperturbed by any of these things. First, I need to establish in that state of mind, for that sadhana is required. So this is Swami Paramarthananda gives a simple story of why sadhana is required, until what. So the wife gave a necklace for him for his birthday, and the husband was so happy and he was wearing it and he wanted to show off. So he walked 4 miles to his friend's house so that he can show, hey, see, look at this, my wife gave this necklace to me. So he all the way walked and told a friend, and friend was admired and congratulated him, and then they chit-chatted for another half an hour or so. Then he returned back home, which is around 4 miles walking. And when he reached home, he realized that he forgot the necklace. He doesn't have the necklace in the neck. So he thought, I must have left it on my friend's place. So, and the wife is going to come pretty soon, and obviously she will ask, where is the necklace? So he ran 4 miles all the way to his friend's house and asked, hey, I must have forgotten my necklace here. Husband says, no, I don't think so. Then they examined and they found out that necklace was in his neck only, but in the folds of his shirt or a collar, and therefore he could not see. So they pointed out, once he discovered that necklace, that which he thought he lost, and he came back home 4 miles back. And question is posed, was that 4 miles of his running necessary to find out the necklace? So if you say yes, that's not true, because he never lost the necklace. He had there all the time. So 4 miles of running was not necessary. If you say it was not necessary, that's also not true. Why? Because this man was so much worried that his wife is going to come and he could not find the necklace, and he had to run 4 miles to discover that he has a necklace. So what is the correct answer? The correct answer is 4 miles of running is necessary to discover that 4 miles of running was not necessary. So same way, all the sadhanas, they are at the mind level, body level, so manasa, vacha, karmana, all activities are required. The puja, japa, all these things, both at the physical level and at the mental level, spiritual activities, as well as the secular activities where I have responsibilities, I think, all that has to be done until that my mind becomes calm and quiet, where I don't have to do any of the activities. So all sadhana is required to discover that all sadhanas was not discovered, because I am there all the time. I don't need to be any of these, because these are all superficial, does not affect me. Therefore, they nalipyate, I am unaffected by any of these activities. And that is therefore tasmat evamevaham astitaha. I am abiding in myself as myself, and in spite of any activities, I am unperturbed, because they are only not real or superficial. So this is essentially Janaka Uvacha. Kaya krutya saha purvam tado vak vistara saha atachinta saha tasmat evameva aham astitaha. So the Shankaracharya says about, it's like a life living in Padma Patra Iva Ambasa. So like a lotus is in the water, where lotus leaf is in the water and grows in the water but unaffected by the water. The same way, this lotus picture is all in Indian gods are all standing in the lotus. You wonder, why is lotus? Lotus is a flower that grows in the mud, and sustained by the mud, but is unaffected by the mud. The beauty of lotus is as it is, in spite of the environment, it shows its beauty. So in spite of environment of all other things, the Mahatma is reveling himself in himself and living like a lotus leaf, unaffected by the any water there. So it is same as evam eva aham astitaha. So Padmapatra eva ambasaha. In the lotus leaf in the water, the sage is reveling in himself by himself. Evam eva aham astitaha. In the Yoga Vasishta, there is a similar saying. Karme vadeho nanudeha eva. Karme vadeho nanudeha eva. Chittam tadevaha vitiha jivaha. Chittam tadevaha vitiha jivaha. Sahajiva iveshvara chitsa atma. Sahajivaha iveshvara chitsa atma. Sarvaha sivaste. Kapadoktametad, sarvaha sivaste kapadoktametad. So body is nothing but the product of past. So deha karmeva deha, because of the activities of the past, this body is come because of the vasanas, and to exhaust the vasanas, I need a particular type of body to exhaust. So I am given a particular type of body. So it is a product of the past activities. Karmeva deha. Na anusa, nanu deha eva. So therefore, even though this is a product of these is actions, I am that which is beyond the body. So I am not the body. Chittam tadeva, tadevaha itiha jivaha. So the jiva comes in the notion that I am this with the mind, but I am none of this. And saha jivaha is nothing, iveshvara chitsa atma, and sarvaha shivastve kapadokta metadu. So shivaha tu ekaha pada uktam. So I am pure Sivaha, Sivoham, Sivoham. Sivoham means auspiciousness, without any impurity of whatever, and that by nature. This is from the Yoga Vasishta. So, Jiva, Jagat, Ishvara, they are all within the realm of transactional reality. Even Jiva and Jagat and Ishvara also at the transactional level, but at the Paramarthika level, there is no Jiva, Jagat, Ishvara, and beyond all that, I am pure Satchidanandam, that is Ekameva Advitiyam. That is the nature of the truth, that is the nature of myself, that is the nature of the world, that is the nature of the Ishvara, that is the nature of everything, because that is the only one, that is the absolute truth. Do sloka 2.
Preetya bhavena sabdadehe. Preetya bhavena sabdadehe. Adrushyatvena chatmanaha, adrushyatvena chatmanaha, vichhepaikagra hrudaya, evameva mastitaha,
together.
Preetya bhavena sabdadehe, adrushyatvena chatmanaha, vichhepaikagra hrudaya, evamevahamastitaha. Preeta abhavena. So for want of satisfaction, preeti, so for want of the pleasures and so on, so sabdadehi, I am attached to the sabda. Sabda means that which source of sabda. I am attached to sound means I am attached to sense objects because of to get the happiness out of it. Sabda includes sabda sparsa rupa rasa gandha. So all five senses are happy only when its sense objects are available, that are sense objects that are conducive to my like, and therefore I am going after it. I get pleased with some kind of sounds, the music and all so on, and some the vision, so appearance of something more kind, and sabda, sparsa, rupa, rasa, gandha. So all five senses are only happy. Gandha means the smell, and rasa means taste. And people are, say, they want this kind of food, that kind of food, and even a subtle difference they cannot tolerate. And all that rasa is only the taste that tongue is used to, and that we go after from one thing to other. People go all the way to taste certain kind of foods that are not available. That's because of the rasam. So pritya bhavena shabdadehi. Shabda adi means shabda sparsa rupa rasa gandha. All five senses are satisfied if they have appropriate sense object that I can enjoy, and I am longing for all my life, going after to satisfy the five senses by indulging in appropriate sense objects. And adrishyatvena cha atmanaha, and the atma also I am trying to look. So now after reasoning Vedanta, I want to go after Atma. So Atma, where can I find Atma? This is adrushyam. Adrushyam means it cannot be, it is imperceptible. So I sit down, I'm trying to visualize Atma, which is imperceptible. All forms of God are visualization of only for to encourage the ekagrata. But after that I have to leave everything and go beyond that. So that this giving up has to be done as a part of the sadhana. So in the Keno Upanishad says you have to give up all this and go beyond. Up to that it's you're okay, that's the Ishvara, but after that you have to leave that. This is essentially you go from each sense point, it points out that you have to give up and go beyond. Until then you need it. After that you have to give up that also. So adrushyatvena cha atmanaha, because it's adrushyam. Adrushyam means it is not seen, though in the Mandukya Upanishad the mantra 7 that defines the atma says na anta pragyam na bahi pragyam na vayata pragyam na prajnana ghanam na pragyam na pragyam adrushyam. It is not seen, it is not an object for you to perceive. So, but what should I, how can I see? You have to intellectually, cognitively recognize that it's beyond anything, but that because of which it is there. So how can I know if it is none of these? In what way I can know? Because pramana operates at these levels where I have to see, or through five senses, or to either through the mind or the intellect. And it says adrushyatvena cha atmana, even the mind cannot see. So that which is yan manasa na manute enahur manomatam tadeva brahma tvam viddhi nedam yadidam upasate yat chakshusha na pasyati ena chakshum supasyati tadeva brahma tvam viddhi nedam yadidam upasate. A student was doing prayers and all that every day, the puja and all that. Says tadeva brahma tvam viddhi nedam yadidam upasate. What you are praying, what you are doing, upasana, prayer, all the puja, all that is not God. That's not Brahman. So, but you told me I had to do all that. You need to do this up to this point. Now you are mature enough to reject all that. Then what is Brahman? And manasa na manute, that which mind cannot think. So it's not something, an object that mind can think. Yan manasana manute yenahur manomatam, that because of which mind can think. Mind cannot think, but that because of which mind has the capacity to think. That which you cannot see, yachushana pasyati yenachakshum supasyati, that because of which mind has the capacity to see. What is that? That is the very life principle. But what is the life principle? Pure consciousness enlivening through this by the Chidabhasa. That is what is tadeva brahma tvam vidhi. No, that is Brahman, not this all other things that are tools that are used initially needed to prepare the mind for this flight. And that's essentially is what implied here. It says adushyatvena chatmanaha. Vichepa eka ekagra hrudaya. So, vichepa ekagrataya. So, I am trying to gain a single pointed vision using the intellect and ekagrata, chitta ekagrata. So, concentrating on that and that alone. By concentration means I have to avoid everything else. So, not this, neti, and trying to find out what is that. But what is that is self-evident all the time. So, in the example I give in this, in the pitch dark room, you say, are you there? Yes, I am there. How do you know you are there? So, I don't need to see. I am not object for a vision. I don't have to think that I am there, therefore I am there. I am able to listen to you, therefore I should be here. It's not that. I am self-evident and self-existing entity. In fact, I don't need any means of knowledge for me to know that I am there. I am aprameyam. So if I avoid all that and turn in the direction of who I am, it has to reveal itself. So it is a realization, recognition or recognition of what I am, even though I am mistaken, because it's evident all the time, it is there all the time, it's known all the time only also, but I am turning outside looking for it. Say, turn inward to see what you are as you are, and it is self, because of which you are able to do all that is that, because of that only. So, you have to cognitively recognize the presence of your own self in every activity, and that is essentially vichepa ekagra shrudaya. All that process of turning to inwards by vichepa, that means is essentially the rejecting everything else and concentrating from rejecting all distractions and concentrating on it until I realize that I am all the time there, the one who is, even when the disturbance, I am there. So, Ketana Upanishad says, Pratibodha Viditam Matam. I don't have to avoid the thought because I am there in the thought also. So, all I need to do is switch my mind from the outside thought of the name form, but turn inwards, that because of which thought is revealed. So, thought revelation involves consciousness plus the thought. So, reject the superficial aspect of it and see the consciousness that pervading every thought that raises in the mind. Because I am conscious of the thought. Without me being conscious of the thought, thought cannot sustain. Thought cannot be there. So, lot of disturbance, Karna. We have to wait. Okay. So that single pointed devotion towards that is essential in terms of beyond any perturbations of any kind. Evameva aham astitaha. I am that alone and abiding in myself, so none of them will be disturbing me because I am there even in those disturbances also. Without me conscious of it, how do I know there is a disturbance? If I say I am being disturbed, that means I am conscious of the disturbance also. So if I pay attention to not the disturbance, but because of which the disturbance is also known. So every thought is known, every activity can be taken place. And that's why someone asked Bhagavan Ramana Maharshi to show him the Lord. I thought you saw the Lord, can you show me? Bhagavan said, if I show you, you won't be able to see it. So don't worry, I have brought all other infrared cameras and this cameras I can capture. I said, okay. Then he did this, folding his fingers and says, can you see? I said, what are you seeing? I'm only seeing folding fingers. That's why I said, you cannot see. It's not something to see, but something to see in terms of intellectually. He says, what is that that makes my fingers to fold and open? That is because this is minerals and carbohydrates. It's a matter doesn't do it. There is a life in me that makes this do. And what is the life? Doctor cannot say what life is. But that because of which the life is expressed in this form. So doctor can say is alive or not only because he is able to talk or he is able to listen. All activities based on that he will say just there is a life. Because without life there cannot be activity. So actually he only measures the activities and infers that there is a life only. Because he doesn't know what life is also. And Vedanta says, it is that because of which you are becoming active. The mind becomes active, the body becomes active. That X factor, that without X is a dead body. With that X, it is something that enlivens the body, makes the body active. That alone is the Brahman. And that understanding is a realization. So, eva meva aham astita. I am, in fact, that alone and pointing in that way. So here Janaka Maharaj is turning our mind attention in that. All perturbations at the body level, at the sense level, at the speech level, at the intellect level cannot really bring in, but that because of which I am conscious of all that plus that which is, it can exist without all that also. Once I realize that without that also, then disturbance will not disturb me. And that is how the self-realization is. A jnani first establishes himself, I am pure consciousness. Then when he comes down, he can see the perturbations, but he can control what he wants and then be active also. So that is what Janaka Maharaj is trying to point out. With that, we'll stop here. Om Purnamada Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vasishyate Om Shanti 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 Harihi Om Sri Guru Bhyo Namaha Harihi Om.